Started off like every other day in my life, at the bottom of a bottle. By noon, I was over my head in bad decisions. All in all, it was pretty typical.
Staring at the cards won't change your hand, Mr. Tate. A bold move. Unfortunately, also a foolish one.
Well, I've never been mistaken for a rocket scientist.
Nor a millionaire, I'm sure. I believe that brings your total just up to over $12,000, Mr. Tate. My assistant here will take your money now.
Take credit cards?
No.
It's all right, I don't have one anyway.
You amuse me, Mr. Tate. However, your debt does not.
My ex-wife would say the same thing.
So luck isn't the only lady to have abandoned you. But I will give you one more chance to court her.
What's this?
Another game of sorts. One empty chamber. If you're lucky enough to land on it, then you walk out of here.
If not?
Well, Mr. Tate, luck's a dime a dance, girl. Let's see if you can soft shoe your way to 10 cents or a bullet. Don't try anything stupid, Mr. Tate. I said I would let you go. I'm a man of my word. Mr. Tate. Not every bullet is meant for you.
All I wanted was a stiff drink and a soft bed. At this point, I'd have to settle for the whiskey.
Thank you.
It's open.
How did you find me?
I picked up a cent of bourbon half a mile back, and I followed it right to you.
You always had a silver tongue.
At least one of us does. Nice place. Are you moving in or hiding out?
Is there a reason you came here tonight?
You're not gonna offer me a drink first? I'm in trouble, Jeff, and I need your help.
You are trouble. You've never needed help a day in your life.
I knew I shouldn't have come here.
Then why did you?
Because I'm scared, Jeff. And I thought you might
what? Forgive and forget?
Help me.
I've got my own problems. I had a million reasons to say no to her. But none of them were very good. Maybe I should have been the nice guy this time. Whatever the reason, the whiskey convinced me it was the right thing to do. Look, honey, I already told you, I can't help you. Not unless it's a warm bed you're. I knew that no matter how long I stared at her, my hand wouldn't change. The cards had been dealt. The chips were on the table. The only thing left to do was to fold and go home.